Lucas Kane.
Master Noctidlan, Kathan Nekli, Kortniklan, Arniklan, Nekmestan, Apanin, Ohani, Islan, Tano.
Thank you.
Lucas's terrifying story haunted me all night long. I had to see him, to talk to him. I had to find out what Agatha had told him. I wanted to look my brother in the eye and hear the truth. I'd never been to his apartment before, and it took me some time to find it. Lucas Kane. That's it. Lucas? Lucas, open the door! Lucas! I could swear that I heard a scream coming from inside. The doorman said Lucas was at home, but he isn't opening. Lucas is in danger. I've got no other choice. Lucas! Oh my God! Lucas, for God's sake, have you lost your mind? What's come over you?
The walls were blown away, and the wind, the tempest, I...
Why did you do this, Lucas? Why?
Somebody tried to kill me.
For heaven's sake, Lucas, there's no one else here but you and I. You were all alone when I arrived. All alone, Lucas.
What's happening to me, Marcus? I don't know what's happening!
It'll be all right, Lucas. Everything will be fine. I'm gonna help you. You'll see.
Sure took your time.
I was in the shower. What do you got?
I got nothing. Dead end. Impossible to ID the page marker found in the book from the restaurant. It's got a series of numeric codes written on it, but it just looks like a lot of numbers to me. I thought you might have some ideas.
Why don't you fax it to me? I wasn't tired anyway. I'm sure it'll make for good bedtime reading.
Okay, I'll send it now. If you get any brainstorms, give me a ring. I'll be here for a while. Tonight's gonna be a long one.
Okay, talk to you later, Tyler.
Thank you.
Haven't had such a cold winter in ages. I hate winter. Everything is silent, motionless. As if everything was dead. Hope it doesn't last long. Who could that be at this hour? Not expecting anyone.
I was feeling kind of bored, and thought as my official friendly neighbor you'd agree to share my boredom. And this excellent bottle of French Chablis.
In my capacity as your friendly neighbor, I wouldn't think of refusing your boring invitation or your excellent wine, Tommy.
I imagine that even a die-hard bachelorette like yourself must have some wine glasses around here somewhere.
I think I do have some. Somewhere. Sit down, Tommy. I'll find them.
A toast?
All right. What to?
To love. What else?
I'll drink to that. Are you with anyone?
Well, actually, I did meet someone 2 weeks ago. He's very real and very nice. And he works in a bank, too. I think this time it could turn into something serious.
I'm happy to see you got your smile back.
We all have our ups and downs, right? I always thought that people in New York didn't give a damn about gayness. They were so enlightened. How wrong I was. They still look at us as being different from so-called normal folks. Are you still single? What's a beautiful girl like you waiting for? Go find yourself a nice guy. If there's one thing New York has lots of, it's handsome men.
I don't know. I guess the desire is just not there. My last romantic experiences were total disasters. I'm not ready for anything or anyone just yet.
Enough small talk. Look at what I brought.
Tarot cards?
I'm going to read your future.
You mean you know how to use those things?
My grandmother was a psychic. She taught me how to read the cards when I was just a kid. She handed down her seeing powers to me. It really works, you know. What the cards foretell always come to pass. Let's see if you're going to meet your true soulmate or if you're going to die as a wrinkled old maid.
Okay, Mr. Gypsy. Tell me what I'm supposed to do.
It's easy. First, take the cards and mix them up. Take two cards. There's going to be a dark period, an escape, and terrible danger. Take two more cards. You're not alone. You're following someone, and he is disturbing. He hides a heavy secret. Take two more cards, please. There is a curse, great suffering and fear. I see dark death and distress. Yes, just come to me whenever you need cheering up. Seriously, I'm sorry, Carla. This is not turning out to be as much fun as I thought.
It's okay, Tommy. Let's see what horrors my destiny holds for me. Here are two more cards.
One child, two destinies, a path toward life, the other path toward death. Carla, I think we'll stop there. I'm sorry, I don't know what happened. It's the first time I've ever read this sort of thing in the cards. Usually don't express anything like this.
Don't apologize, Tommy. It's just a silly game. I never believed in fortune-telling anyway.
Well, I've got to get home. It's late. Good night, Carla.
Good night, Tommy. It was real nice talking. Don't wait so long next time, okay?
I promise.
Is my future that grim? You mentioned a child. I don't believe in this stuff, but it's always a little scary, whatever you think of it.
There is one dish that is better than roast chicken, and that's duck meets the potatoes. Excellent. It's wonderful.
We have a strong cold front moving our way, coming down from Canada, bringing with it heavy snow and very windy conditions all down the coastal region. The temperatures are several degrees below normal for this time of year. Let's take a look at the satellite view of this front.
Normally, I don't like leaving Sam home alone, especially now. But this bookmark had me intrigued. I had a gut feeling that I was holding the key that would identify our killer. I felt like I was closing in on him, and I wasn't about to go home to sleep until I figured out what this paper meant. Man, nothing but stock quotes. How can anyone possibly decipher these things? Wait a minute. That's it. I gotta call Carla right away.
Hello?
It's a list of stock quotes, Carla. Our bookmark was printed in a bank.
Of course! It's so obvious. How'd you figure that out?
I opened the paper to the stock quotes page and it was right under my nose the whole time. Now we just have to figure out which bank printed it.
Can you fax me the bookmark? I think I have an idea. I'll call you right back. I'm really sorry to bother you, Tommy.
No problem. I wasn't ready for bed yet anyway. What can I do for you?
It's about one of my investigations. I thought maybe you could help me with a question I have. I was wondering, is there a way to identify a bank from a list of stock quotes that they've printed?
Normally, yeah. Banks always use watermarked paper, which shows the bank's ID code.
The ID code is printed on a watermark? All right, I'll check our document to see. Thanks, Tommy. Good night.
Night, Carla.
That's it. I've got to call Tyler.
Yeah?
Our bookmark should be watermarked with the bank's ID code.
I'll check it out and call you right back.
I think I found it.
Tyler?
I've got the code. You should have no trouble identifying which bank it corresponds to.
This time we've got our killer. I think I'll pay a little visit to the bank tomorrow.
You want me to go?
No, I'd rather go myself, if you don't mind. I'd like to see what our boy looks like. We'll meet afterwards at the station and compare notes. See you tomorrow, Tyler.
Okay, see you then, Carla.
I finally convinced Marcus to let me go out. I'd slept most of the day, and he'd stayed to watch over me. I needed to get out and get back in touch with reality. My physical condition was deteriorating rapidly. My mental state wasn't much better. I could feel myself slipping away. I knew that it wouldn't be long before I lost it.
Hello, I'm Detective Carla Valenti, NYPD.
The police, they found me.